Ladies and gentlemen, and most importantly, dear friends, good evening to everyone. Could you please come closer to this body? On behalf of the organizers of this exhibition, UNDP Office in Belarus, Ramapo Chernobyl Project, Chernobyl Children International and the Panama Commission of Belarus to the United Nations, I'm honored to welcome you all at its opening ceremony. Tonight, 31 years after the disaster of Chernobyl struck, we come together in the first commemoration of the International Chernobyl Disaster Remembrance Day. For 3 decades, each year we commemorated the tragedy and loss of Chernobyl. This feeling will stay with people in Belarus and the most affected countries for generations to come. We are thinking of all the lessons the tragedy of Chernobyl taught us over those years. One lesson is worth not being just remembered, but celebrated. You read it in the title of that exhibition. Empathy and compassion can heal. Love should and will overcome evil and indifference. Over the years, dozens of countries, thousands of concerned individuals helped the people, especially the children in Belarus and the most affected countries, to deal with the aftermath of the Chernobyl tragedy. Their admirable work of art was recognized and celebrated today with gratitude world over. Here, in New York, we decided to honor the lifetime achievement of two of the non-governmental partners from the United States and Ireland that the mission of Belarus to the UN has been most closely collaborating on Chernobyl all those years. It is the Ramapo High School Children of Chernobyl Project, led by Donald Kearns. And Chernobyl Children International Foundation, led by Amy Roach. Before giving the floor to the distinguished representatives of our honorees, I would like to invite you to listen to the address on behalf of the President of the General Assembly of the United Nations, and I give the floor to the Special Advisor of the President of the General Assembly, Ambassador Janis Reyes. Excellency,